Now, you may have been put off by actually making tongue, but it is very easy indeed. You need to give your butcher plenty of warning if you're going to have want a tongue. I would give them as much as 10 days notice, because it has to be soaked in a brine. And you can't make the brine yourself, because you can't get saltpeter from the chemist anymore, because they use it in bomb making. So I've got a tongue that's ready to be cooked now, and when you get it home you want to soak it for about 24 hours in cold water, because that takes a little bit of the saltiness away. But check with your butcher, he may say soak it for a little bit less. So take the tongue and put it in cold water. This is an ox tongue. You'll pay something about 70, maybe 80 pence a pound for it. Just going to turn that down at the back. Put it into water, see that it's covered with cold water. Then bring it to the boil and simmer it until it's tender. And this will be about something like 3.5 hours. But also, to give it some flavour, add an onion that's got a few cloves stuck into it, and a couple of bay leaves. And then that just adds a little bit of extra flavour. Another tongue that you can use is a pig's tongue that could be salted in brine. This is for perhaps if you're on your own or just two of you, because we have a lot of letters from people who are living on their own, and they say that sometimes the recipes are for too many. Now, a pig's tongue only costs 30 pence a pound, so that's a good buy. And you can do it in a similar way, but when it comes to pressing it, you just press it in a carton, because it's small, something an old margarine carton. So I'll pop that underneath. And now, once it's cooked, I've got a cooked one here, take it out of the pan using two spoons, put it in cold water, then you can take the skin off. You've got to get it cool so that you can handle it. So take it out of the pan. I'll get rid of that water. And then you can take the skin off quite easily. First of all, you'll find one or two bones in it. Take those out, they're down the back. And then take the skin off. Put your finger underneath the skin and it really peels off remarkably easily. To tell when it's done, you take a skewer and press it into the thin part of the tongue, and then it should feel soft. There we are. Now you can see that the skin peels off very easily indeed. Take it all off. Take off any surplus fat and then cut it in half. And I've got one just to that stage here. So I've cut this one in half, and then you want to mould it. In the old days, I think they used to do it in a tin, or you can do it in anything that's the right round shape, about 6 inches. So cut it in half and put the cut side down to the bottom of the dish, pressing it really well down. That gives it a nice top and a surface. Then take the other part, and you've got the bits of skin and bone that have been left, and put that on top, and then press it in. It takes a bit of squeezing. There we are. And if it's fairly moist, you should find that you don't really need any more stock, but if you like, you can take the stock and concentrate it, boil it, and pour a little bit more stock in. And then you press it, and you need a saucer for that. Put it on top, and then a weight on top of that. Now, maybe you haven't got a weight. You can always put a pan, a saucepan of water on top of that to give it a press. Or you could use some tins of baked beans or something. It really needs to be weighted down and put in the refrigerator. And I've got one in the fridge already. Just have a rub on a dry towel. Here we are. Such a lovely thing to have for a picnic or something like that. So, first of all, the little one I was talking about, that's the pig's one that only costs 30 pence a pound, done in a carton. That needs to be turned out once it's cold, and it does make rather a nice meal for one or two. And then here's the big one without the weight, and it's all set. Give it a push. Now, you might need to put it in hot water. Let's give it a shake. It's coming, I can hear it. There we are. And it looks beautifully professional and special for a special occasion. And then you want to serve it sliced. It slices very easily, and garnish it with a bit of parsley. And then when you've taken a few slices off, keep it in the fridge.